The fundamental cause of the trouble in the Far East is the lawless condition in China. The impossible reign of self-will in that country without recognizing on her part.
China has long been derelict in her international duties as a sovereign state, and Japan as her nearest neighbor has been the greatest sufferer on that score. The adoption of this report would give the impression to the Chinese that they had been exonerated from all responsibility, that they could continue to defy Japan with impunity.
The two peoples ought to be friends and should cooperate with each other for their common welfare. By the adoption of the report before you, however, the Assembly would not be helping us, either Japanese or Chinese.
It would serve further to embitter the feelings of the Japanese and Chinese peoples. I ask you not to adopt this report for the sake of peace in the Far East and for the sake of peace throughout the world.
The dramatic moment has arrived. The chairman announces the result of the ballot. 42 nations out of the 44 present condemn Japan's Manchurian policy.
I call on His Excellency, Mr. Matsuoka, delegate of Japan.
It is a matter of common knowledge that Japan's policy is fundamentally inspired by a genuine desire to guarantee peace in the Far East and to contribute to the maintenance of peace throughout the world. Japan, however, finds it impossible to accept the report adopted by the Assembly.